Right up in the Scottish Islands today, in Cul Mor. So I've got my usual 15 by 11 watercolour paper, large hake, raw sienna, and then I'm going to go into ultramarine blue. I'm just going to paint the sky you can see between the clouds. So that'll do for that. I put that bit in there because there's a lake down here. So I've got the reflection of the sky in there straight away. I ain't going to mess about doing that later. So now I'm going to put the clouds in. So I'm going alizarin crimson, Payne's grey. Just putting these in just in the little gaps where I've left the between the blue, so it's in the you've got the white of the cloud, you've got the big grey clouds in there. I'm just going to put a bit in the foreground, and that's enough for the sky. Now we've got some big distant mountains there, so I'm going back into the sky colours. Predominantly blue, because the cooler colours help push it right back into the distance. And then we've got that one sort of sits up like that. That's the furthest mountain. A little bit closer, I'm going to go into a bit of light red, raw sienna, a bit more water, I think. A light red, raw sienna, just a touch of the blue. And these mountains, a bit more of the red, oop, too much, more of the raw sienna. And that disappears somewhere over there. I won't worry too much about this area because we have some trees there. Now on this far shoreline, we've got the foothills of these big mountains. We've got some trees. So I'm going to go lemon yellow and Payne's grey. Nice dark, rich greeny colour. I'm just going to put this tree lining. Make sure it's level. That'll do for that. I've also got some trees. I'm going to stick with the same colour. Again, lemon yellow. Payne's grey, maybe a touch of the ultramarine. And then just sort of hit and miss with the corner of the hake. And try and vary the height of these trees as well. nice and dark at the bottom. Bring that right down, because these trees are this side of the lake. And we can go in with some scraps of the fingernails, just to add a few branches and whatnot. Now, I'm just going to make sure that this is dry. So I'm going to put the reflection of those bark trees so I'm just going to wet the water area, and then strong mix, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, and just pull that down. That'll do for that. Dry that before it starts running all over the place. Carry on. I'm just going to pull this paper tight now, it's stretched. The next thing I'm going to do, we've got some more trees there on the right hand side that are slightly closer. I'll try and vary the colour a bit more with these, I think. I'll start up here.